Hello friend, welcome back. In our previous video, I just segment all that our page in our master blade. Here I included the top page, that included the header page, included the footer page, and also this content part. So this content part will be the dynamic, and also I created one of the pages as a home blade. And into this position, I just added all that our content. And also here I extend our this master page. So right now I want to update our routes. Okay, before that was the by default home page, that was actually the welcome. So if you go to these positions, like that is our main directory. Okay, so if you click on enter, you can see that is actually by default the Laravel page. So here and now I want to load our home template, that means this page. For doing this, first of all we have to create one of the controller. And I already discussed about that things with you, how can create the controller. Like here, that is our directory. So that is actually our news directory. And here, first of all, I just added the CMD. And into this position, now I want to create one of the controller for our home page. Okay. So here, what exactly you have to do? I think it's very much clear to you. So right now, I want to create one of the controller. So I have to write as a PHP artisan and make the controller. Okay, and now I want to create one of the controller as a home page controller, and now I click on the enter. So now here you can see it's now showing as a controller created successfully. So if you go to this area, that means in our controller folder, and here there is a home page controller. And into this controller here I want to create one of the method. Like here I define the public and then function. And then I want to create one of the methods index. Okay, so I already discussed about that things with you. So here there is the index method, and here I want to view our page. That means in our form folder, that is our home blade. Okay, so I want to actually link up that page, link on particular this position. So here I want to return it. Okay, return, and then I just define that view. And view where view we have to assign our file location in our font folder, that is a home page. Okay, so that means that is a home blade page, that means this page. So here I assign our layout. Now we have to update our routes. Okay, that means these routes. And here there is a function, so right now we don't need that functions. Okay, I just removed all the things from here. And into this position, first of all, added our controller name. So I already created one of the controller as a home page controller. And here I just assigned the home page controller. And I already created one of the method for this one. Like here, I just defined the @, and then our method name, our method is index. So here I just defined that index. So I already discussed about that basic. Now you can see I just apply that things in our real project. So here I just define the controller, and here I just define our method name, and that is our main root directory. So for now, let's check this out. So now here, if you click on the save all, I just click on the save all, and now that it was actually the Laravel by default page. Now I just click on the refresh that page. Yes, now you can see our home blade is now perfectly loaded on here, and also footer contain part and the footer part, that is our all that contain part, and that is also the header part, CSS and JSS, all that file is perfectly now loaded on for particular disposition. So I hope you can well understand about it, how the things I did for our index page. So for now here that is our index. So I just loaded that method. So in our method here I just extend that return that page, that means that view and the font and then the home. For the designs, our root URL, so here there is our root URL is now visible that page. I hope you can well understand about it. So we perfectly done our work in our for that index page. And also we have the another page, like we have also another the category page. So that is actually the category page. We also have to make that things dynamic, and also we have to segment that page. Okay, and also there is another page as a single. So if you go to the this position, like there is another page as a single.html. So we also have to do that work. So step by step I will do it. So in the next video I will actually customize that category.html page. So thanks for watching this video. I will see you in the next video.